Welcome.
Hello, and welcome all to the Nonlinear Characterization and Modeling through Post-IV Parameters and S-Parameters web seminar. My name is Patrick Jespersen, and I will be your host for today. Today we will hear a presentation by Steve Dutkiewicz from Maui Microwave Corporation. Additionally, we will have Tony Gasseling, co-founder from MCAT Engineering Company, and Hiro Mahara, application expert and product marketing engineer at Agilent Technologies, as your presenters for today. For everybody's comfort, this is a lecture-style meeting only. However, you can send in questions at any time through the Q&A functionality of the WebEx tool on the right bottom hand of your screen. We will try to do our best to answer all your questions during the session, but may come back to you after if we haven't been able to. Please be reminded that this webcast will be recorded so you can review and share with your colleagues at any time. And with that, I would like to hand off to our first presenter, Steve.
Thank you very much, Patrick, and thank you everyone for showing up today. We know your time is valuable. You could be at a pub watching a football match, but instead you're spending the next hour with us talking about modeling, so we definitely appreciate your dedication. Today the topics will basically start off with an introduction to modeling, followed by an explanation of the core device model extraction, then a little bit about model enhancement, and finally, model validation. And with that, we should be able to cover all the different requirements and things to look out for when creating a compact model. So to start off, we want to take a look at what are the types of large signal transistor models that are most common on the market today. Really, if you take a look at what's available, it breaks down into about three groups: physical models, compact models, and behavioral models. Physical models, as the name suggests, are based on the physics of the device. They are completely based on complex model equations that best represent the actual physics of the device, the inside of the device. But because they're not based on measurements, because they're based solely on the physics of the device, they are the most complex and complicated to develop. Compact modeling is based on pulsed IV and pulsed S parameter data, which is then used to fit equations. These models take into account electro-thermal effects, trapping effects, low frequency and high frequency memory effects, and are best suitable for die level applications. With the compact models, we get great physical insight into the device. And this model is best used for the transistor manufacturers, transistor designers that really need to understand their device. Behavioral models are referred to as black box models, where we know nothing about the device that's actually being modeled. All we know is how the device responds to a set of stimuli. This device can be anything, a package device, a die, it could be a mixer, and it's ideal for those working in systems that need to know how does this black box widget respond as part of a larger whole. So again, with compact models, we're talking about usefulness being for transistor designers, people that need insight into the device, that need to know about the scalability of the device, to need to know how it will work outside, to extrapolate, people that are working really at a die level. And behavioral models are really good for system engineers and advanced amplifier designers that want to go and design a system or see how a widget behaves as part of a larger system, not necessarily caring about what the device itself is. This presentation will concentrate specifically on the compact modeling approach. When we take a look at the commercially available compact FET models on the market today, you'll notice some pretty common names: the Curtis model, the CFET model, Angelov model, of course our AMCAD model. And each of these models are defined by a specific number of parameters, as well as if they take into account electrothermal effects, just self-heating, trapping effects, and what they were designed for. And if you take a look at this table, you can see that the AMCAD HEMT model is the only model that takes into account electrothermal effects and trapping effects and was designed specifically for GaN devices. Let's take a quick look at the compact FET model extraction flow. So with this, we start off with small signal S parameters. And the small signal S parameters are used to determine the extrinsic parameters of the device, which correspond to the pads, the via holes that connect the transistor to the ground, gate and drain access. And from there, we're able to extract the intrinsic parameters by calculations using well-documented equations. We then use pulsed IV measurements to extract the diodes in current source models under quasi-isothermal conditions. We use synchronized pulsed S parameters to extract the nonlinear capacitance models that are needed for simulations under large signal operating conditions. And then we can enhance the model by taking into account thermal properties. So if we have a thermal chuck, we can take this model and we can expand it over different temperatures. And we can expand the model to cover trapping effects from various quiescent bias points. So this is the flow. We start off with small signal S parameters, go into the pulsed IV data, go into the pulsed S parameter data, and if we want to expand on that, worry about thermal chucks and trapping effects. And once we have these various model components, we bring them all together into the model schematic for the AMCAD HEMP model available in ADS. Moving on, let's talk a little bit about core device model extraction. The model extraction really comprises of two distinct steps. The first is the measurement, and the measurement is used to extract pulsed IV and pulsed S parameter data. And then from there, we use that set of data to develop our model. So I'm going to concentrate specifically on the first part of it, on the measurement part, pulsed IV and pulsed S parameter data. The idea behind pulsed IV measurements is to bias the transistor at a quiescent bias point